John chapter 11, verse 1 to 4. John chapter 11, verse 1 to 4. The Bible says, John 11, verse 1 to 4. Now a certain man was sick, Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. It was that Mary who anointed the Lord with fragrant oil and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore the sister sent to him, saying, Lord, behold, him whom you love is sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through it. The title of the message is, During Tough Times. Bible talks here of a friend of Jesus who is sick, and the sisters, Mary and Martha, they sent a message to Jesus that your friend, him whom you love, is sick. Bible says in Psalm 34 verse 19, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver him from them all. And that is my message to you today, that God will deliver us. It's true, even as friends of Jesus, even as believers and followers of Christ, at times many are our afflictions, many are our challenges. We go through such seasons of trials, seasons that are tough. So what do you do when you find yourself in such a season? How do you carry out? How do you come out even in that season? A season that is tough, that is difficult, that is a trying moment, a challenging time. I want to share with us three things that can help us even during our tough times. Number one, get to Jesus. Number one, get to Jesus. Pray about it. Whether it is your difficult time, or whether maybe it's a loved one, or a friend, or a neighbor, somebody close to you who is going through a tough time, you can get them to Jesus. You can talk to Jesus about your situation or about that person's situation. You can commit it to God in prayer. You see, there are many important things to do when you are. There are many things to do when you are in problems. But I put it to us, prayer should be the first thing. There are other things that you need to do, but prayer should be the first thing. Prayer is the most important thing that you can do. I remember at one time when John the Baptist was beheaded by Herod the Tetrarch, there in Matthew chapter 14, Bible says in verse 12, after the disciples of John had buried him, they took the message to Jesus. They told Jesus about it. Then in Matthew 14 and verse 12, you talk it with the Lord. You commit it to God in prayer. Whatever afflictions you're going through, whatever frustrations you're going through, tell it to Jesus. I mean, commit that person to Jesus. Commit yourself to Jesus. In Mark chapter 2, starting from verse 1, Jesus is preaching in Capernaum. He's in the house and there's a crowd. But then the Bible says there were four people in that village who had a cripple in their house. I mean, this man was paralyzed. He was a limitation, was a hindrance to these four friends. I mean, they had to feed him, they had to take him to the washroom, they had to be around him constantly. When they heard that Jesus has visited their village, they took their problem, they took this limitation, they took this challenge, this affliction, they took it to Jesus. And you know the story how the man was healed miraculously. And these people were liberated. Why? Because they got it, they took it to the Lord. They took it to the presence of the Lord. A man called Jairus, a leader of the synagogue, in Mark chapter 5, Bible says his daughter, his 12-year-old daughter, was sick, close to die. But then the Bible says that Jairus went to Jesus. He took the situation, he took that challenge, he took that which was threatening his family, he took it to Jesus. And you know the story how Jesus would go and resurrect this girl, because by the time Jesus arrived, the girl is already dead. So that's what I'm encouraging us today. Take your situation, take your tough times Their brother is sick, but they realize that they have a friend, they have a family friend, and his name is Jesus, and they took it to the Lord. So whatever is overwhelming you, whatever is a challenge or affliction to you, you can pray about it, you can commit it to God, even help to guarantee you, even before God gets you out of that tough time. Let me tell you, the moment you pray, there is a peace, there is serenity, there is peace that God provides to you, even when you are still in those tough times. That is the beauty of getting your situation to Jesus. That even before you come out of the situation, even before the COVID-19, you know, is totally resolved, we who have the secret of getting our situation to the Lord, we will continue to enjoy peace. Philippians 4 verse 6 and 7. Philippians 4 verse 6 and 7, the Bible says, be anxious of nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And then verse 7 says, and the peace of God that surpasses human understanding shall guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. There's a peace you receive when you commit yourself to the Lord, when you commit your situation to the Lord. And this peace I'm talking of the peace that surpasses human understanding. In other words, when God begins to minister to those who pray, those who get their situation to Him, He bypasses their brains and He deposits peace in their hearts. That's the peace, that's the kind of peace that I'm talking about. A peace that you cannot explain logically. But it's a peace that Peter had in Acts chapter 12. Acts chapter 12. James had just been beheaded by Herod. And when Herod saw that killing James, it pleased the Jews and the people, he planned to behead Peter the following day. But the Bible says, Peter was sound asleep. How do you sleep when you know that tomorrow your head will be cut? I only have one answer to that. And the answer is that even as Peter was in prison, waiting to be beheaded the following day, the Bible says the church was praying constantly for him. They are in Acts of the 12. That's what I'm talking about. Maybe your parent is losing his or her mind. Maybe your friend is losing his or her mind. Maybe something is treated in your neighbor or somebody who you love, or your family is being treated, or you yourself are being treated. You can enjoy peace. You can have peace. You can overcome. And how do you do that? You get it to the Lord. You pray. The church was praying for Peter. And as long as the church was praying about that situation, Peter was enjoying peace. There was a victory for Peter. So number one, get your situation to the Lord. Get it to Jesus. Talk to the Lord about your afflictions, about your problems. It's unfortunate that we do all other things, but we have neglected prayer. Yet it's the number one thing towards our deliverance, towards our redemption. Number two, get there. Do you have a friend? Do you have someone who is going through problems, who is going through afflictions? Do you have a situation that is tough? You can get there. You can just be there. I mean, be available. Be available. I mean, avail yourself to this person or to whatever is happening. The Bible says that a message went to Jesus. Your friend, the one that you love, is sick. Jesus stayed 4 days, but finally he went. He went, he was available, he went there. And the Bible says that even he went, he felt with mother and Mary and those who are mourning the death of Lazarus. He was just there. He didn't even explain why he was late, because Jesus knows that at times later is better. At times later is better. He came late, but God was going to do even a bigger and a greater and a better miracle for his friends, mother and Mary. And at times, that's all you need to do. Just be there with those who are weeping. Just be there with those who are going through tough times. Just be there. At times, you may not even have answers. I'm reminded of the friends of Job in Job chapter 2. Job chapter 2, when Job was going through his tough times, his trials and temptations, and he's losing everything. He has lost his 10 sons. He's losing his health. He has lost his riches. Bible says his friends, when they arrived, for 7 days, they never opened their mouth. But they were there with him. In fact, trouble came or trouble arose when they opened their mouth. they try to give answer. You know, they try to give explanation. They try to give theology on what was happening with Job. That is when problems arose in this issue. But as long as they were there, that was enough. And at times, people who are going through tough times, all they need is your presence. Is you being with them. Is you, you know, they just need your shoulder. Don't even try to give answers. Don't try to give, you know, reasons why they are going through the tough times. Pray for them. But after you pray for them, just be available. Be there for that sister. Be there for that brother. Be with them. And Jesus arrived in the house of Mary and Martha, who are mourning the death of their brother. So number one, we are saying, pray. Get it to Jesus. Is someone going through a tough time? Are you going through a tough time? Just get it to Jesus. Number two, just be there. Be there in the house of God. Be there. Don't run away from church. Don't run away from your family. Don't run away from your business because things are tough. No, just be there. Get it to Jesus in prayer and then just be there. And if it's someone else who's going through a tough time, just be there. Walk with them. Be there with them. Then number three, let Jesus. Number three, let Jesus. Let Jesus be. Bible says in the story of Martha and Mary, Jesus wept. And then he says to Martha and Mary, where have you laid him? I mean, you're going to be attacked, he's lost. You've lost your brother, Lazarus. You're mourning, you're going through your tough times, your difficult moments as a family. Where? Show me where the problem is. Then the Bible says that when they arrived at the tomb, Jesus said to Martha and Mary, roll away the stone. But Martha said to Jesus, Lord, he's been dead for 4 days. There is a stench. It's stinking now. And Jesus says to Martha, did I tell you that if you believe, you shall see the glory of God? Jesus is saying, I am the life and I am the resurrection. It is me. Let me. Put your focus on me. Remove your eyes. Remove your focus from people and even from your situation. Let me. See me. I am alive. I'm on the throne. Jesus said in John 16 and verse 33. John 16 verse 33. Jesus said, be of good cheer. Rejoice. In this world, you shall have many tribulations. But be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Jesus is saying, tribulation will be there. As long as in this world, tough times, those seasons, you will experience them. You will go through the valley of the shadow of death. You will go through fire. You will go through floods. But the Lord says that, I have overcome the world. John, the Revelator, in the island of Patmos, which was a difficult and hard place. I mean, he'd been thrown there to die. It's a seemingly God-forsaken place. It's a very dry place. An island, he's all alone. Then he sees this vision there in Revelation 5, verse 1 to 5. In Revelation 5, verse 1 to 5, John writes, in the island of Patmos, you know, in a place forgotten and forsaken, just maybe like where you are right now, feeling that you're trapped time, you are isolated. Bible says that John the Revelator, he saw the one sitting at the right hand, at the throne, the one sitting at the throne, and in his right hand, there was a scroll and there was a seal. And then there was a strong angel, verse 2, who proclaimed, saying, who is worthy to open the scroll and to loose the seal? And the Bible says in verse 3, there was nobody in heaven or on earth, and even under the earth, there was no one who was found worthy to open the scroll and to loose the seal, even to read it or even to look at it. Bible says in verse 4, when John saw that there is nobody to open the scroll or to loose the seal, he wept. Then an elder, one of the 24 elders, says to John the Revelator, weep not, because the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, he has prevailed to open the scroll and to loose the seal. And that's what I'm talking about today. Maybe you are there weeping, you are there confused, frustrated, because there's nobody in heaven, there's no one on earth.
the angels in heaven, not even the leaders on earth, nobody even under the earth is able to sort you out, is able to solve your problems. The Lord is saying to you today, weep not. Put your focus on Jesus. Put your eyes on Jesus. He has prevailed. He's not in the grave. He's the one seated on the throne. And the Lion of the tribe of Judah, this root of David, talking of Jesus, he has prevailed to open every scroll and to lose every seal. All I'm reminding you is that put your eyes on Jesus. Put your focus on him. If you do that, then you shall know that he's alive. He's interceding for you. Hebrews 7 verse 25. Hebrews 7 verse 25, the Bible says, therefore, he is able to save us to the uttermost, seeing that he ever lives to make intercession for us. He did it for Martha and Mary and all those who were mourning when Lazarus had died. When Jesus came, he made all the difference. And I want to put it to you, you who is weeping like John the Revelator, confused and frustrated, in consternation, like Martha and Mary, just let Jesus, just allow him to do that which only he can do. No angel in heaven, no human being on earth, not even the devil under the earth. Nobody is able to do that which God is able to do for you. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or even imagine. And he's touched by the feelings of our infirmities. Are you feeling you're going through a tough and a trial and temptation? Hebrews 2 verse 18. Hebrews 2 verse 18. The Bible says that since he was tempted in every area, he's able to help those who are being tempted. And when you go to chapter 4 verse 15, chapter 4, Hebrews 4 verse 15, the Bible says that therefore we don't have a high priest who cannot be touched by the feelings of our infirmities, but he's able to help us. He's able to aid all those who are tempted. He's touched, he sympathizes with your crying, with your pain. He was tempted. He knows what you're going through. Therefore, all I'm putting to ask you is that, do you want peace? Peace as a passes human understanding? Do you want to go successfully through your tough times? Focus on Jesus. Let Jesus, let him be Lord. Let him be God. Isaiah 26 verse 3. Isaiah 26 verse 3, the Bible says that he keeps him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on him. So even when you are in that lack, in that valley, or the mountains are big before you, put your mind in Christ. Put your focus on Jesus. Wait on the Lord. Look at him. And if you do that, then you shall under, he's going to give you this peace, perfect peace. He's the Prince of Peace, Isaiah 9 verse 6. He's the Prince of Peace. He will comfort you. He will strengthen you. All you need is Jesus in that situation. You need to invoke his presence in your tough times. You need a manual, not a manual. Not steps to get out of your tough times. Not keys. Not a program. No, you need a pastor. Not a program. You need a pastor. And the pastor that you need is Jesus. You need Emmanuel. God with us. Think of Daniel. Think of Daniel chapter 3, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. When they are thrown in the fire. I mean, the Lord appeared. When did the Lord appear? When did they get linked with the Lord? When did they enjoy intimacy with Jesus? Not when they were about to get into the fire. Not when they were around the fire. But when they were in the fiery trial. When they were going through their tough times. That is when they were linked with the Lord. That is when they enjoyed intimacy, fellowship with Jesus. And those tough times never consumed Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And you too shall not be consumed. You shall not be finished by the temptations that have been brought on your way. If anything, the only thing that was banned was the ropes that were limiting Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The only thing that was banned were the enemies, those who are throwing Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to the fire. You too, you will enjoy the presence of God, even in your tough times. And you know what? They were not even in a hurry to walk out. They were not in a hurry to walk out of the fire. Because to the three Hebrew boys, they would rather be in the fire with Jesus than be in the palace without the law. I submit to you that as you let Jesus be Lord in your life, as you allow God be God in your situation, He will deliver you from all the afflictions. But even before He delivers you, He will be with you. He will stand with you. He will comfort you. He will free you from every kind of bondage that is limiting your progress, that is limiting your rising up. Get your situation to Jesus in prayer. Talk to the Lord in the morning, in the noontime, in the evening. Talk to God about that situation, about that past. And just be there. Continue in the fear of God. Continue in the kingdom of God. Continue, loving Him and doing your devotions and serving God. Even in your fiery trials and in your tough times. Finally, we are talking of let Jesus, let Him be, let Him handle that situation. Don't try to handle it in your own wisdom. Don't try to handle it the way men handle their situations. We are new kingdom. The Lord is on the throne, and He has prevailed over every storm and to lose every sin. There is no temptation that come on your way, but such as is common to man. And God is faithful. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 13. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 13. God is faithful. He will never allow you to be tempted beyond what you can bear. But He will, with the temptation, make a door of escape that you may be able to bear. I want you to understand that during your tough times, during your fiery trials, when the Lord puts in that oven, or when He allows you to be in the fire, I want you to understand that one hand, one God's hand is on the temperature gauge. He's the one who determines how much fire you go through. But also, the other hand is on the timing. He's the one who determines how long you're going to stay in that fire. In other words, what I'm saying is that the Lord is in control. He will never allow you to be tempted beyond what you can bear. He's the one who controls the duration. And He's the one who controls the temperatures, the amount of the fire, the temptation, the trials that you're going through. I finish with Revelation 16 verse 7. Revelation 16 verse 7. John the Revelator in the island of Patmos. He who saw the Lord, the glorified Jesus, sitting on the throne, ruling and reigning and in control of the situation. And he who had a voice from an elder, that the lion of the tribe of Judah, the little baby, has prevailed to open the scroll and to lose the seal. He says in Revelation 16 verse 7, true and righteous are your judgments, O God. True and righteous.
Forever, Lord God Almighty.
In the mighty name of Jesus, also pray.